What's going on, guys? In this video, we are going to build a Docker container for our Golang application. And before doing that, we are going to quickly set up Go modules that will allow us to manage the application dependencies efficiently and also will help us to download those libraries to build and run the application using Docker containers. Remember to subscribe to the channel and remember to download the Golang cheat sheet. There is a link in the description below this video. Okay, this is the Golang application that we've been working on. It's applying a clean architecture approach. So we are independent of the database. We're independent of the HTTP router that we want to use. In this case, we're using Max, but we can also use Qi router, or we can use Shingonic. And in this case, we are using SQLite as the database, but we can use any other database such as Firebase, MySQL, Postgres, or any other database engine. Okay, now we are going to set up Go modules in our application, and then we are going to make a few changes, mostly related with package names. And after that, we are going to create the Docker file to build the Docker image. First, I'm going to initialize the module for the application. So I'm going to run Go mod init. And here the convention is to use the repo URL. So I'm going to grab that from GitLab. And I'm going to remove HTTPS. Okay, I'm going to run this. And this is going to create this go.mod file. And now we need to use this package name and apply that name here in all the local folders that we are using to declare the packages that we need to import on each file. So I'm going to do that. Okay, I already changed all the dependencies to include the module name for the application. We can see that it's going to automatically declare all the external libraries that we are using here in the go.mod file. And also it's going to create this go.zoom file where it includes all the URLs that it's using to download dependencies. And it's going to associate a hash to each download. So using this hash is going to ensure that future downloads of these modules will retrieve the same content, the same bits as the first download. Okay, before creating the Docker file, I'm going to make a few changes here. So I'm going to remove this. We are not going to use it anymore. And I'm going to remove this port declaration from here. And I'm going to use an environment variable so I can include that environment variable setup within the Docker file when I create the image. So I'm going to remove this. And I'm going to use the OS library to access the environment variable. And I'm going to use the getenv function. And here I'm going to pass the name of the environment variable. Then in this case, it's going to be the port where the HTTP server is going to be listening in the application. So I already exported that environment variable. So we can see it here. Echo $port, and I already assigned the port 8000 for that environment variable. So let's run just to check that everything is still working. Go run, and as we can see, the application is running on port 8000. So let's quickly check that everything is working as we expect. So we don't get any posts, so I'm going to create one. I'm able to create it. And if we go here again and we execute the get request, yeah, we get the post that we just created. So everything's still working. I'm going to close this. And now I'm going to create the Docker file. Okay, I'm going to create a new file then here. New file, it's gonna be Docker file. I'm going to close this. Okay, I'm going to close others. Okay. At first, we need to use a base Golang image. So we need to use from, and here we need to include a base image. In this case, we're going to use the latest Golang Docker image that is going to include all we need to run our application. It's going to include a Linux installation, and it's going to include the latest Golang version. So I need to, Golang latest. Okay, the next thing is going to be label, and here I'm going to include the maintainer info. In this case, it's going to be my information. So this is going to be maintainer. And it's going to be myself, and here I need to include the email. Hello at pragmaticreviews.com. Okay, the next thing is going to be the current working directory inside the container. So this is going to be workdir, and here is going to be /app, like that. Okay, the next thing that we need to include is we need to copy these two files. The go.mod file, where we have all the dependencies that are required to run the application, and the go.sum that includes all these hashes. So we need to copy. The source is going to be go.mod. And we need to use another one. And we need to use period to specify the destination folder. And in this case, it's going to be the workdir that we specified here. And here we need to copy go.sum. And we also need to use period to specify the current folder in the container. Okay, so the next thing that we need to do is we need to run go mod download. This is going to download all the dependencies that we define here in the go.mod file. The next thing that we need to do is we need to copy all these files to the container. So here we use copy all the files recursively to the destination that's going to be the current directory within the container, that is this one, /app. Okay, the next thing that we are going to do is specify this environment variable, the port environment variable. So let's do that. So we need to use env, like this. And here's going to be port, and the value is going to be 8000. Now, what we need to do is we need to build the application. So we need to include run, go, build. And finally, we need to specify the command that we want to run once the container is initialized. So cmd, and here we need to specify the command. If we run here, go build, we're going to see that this Golang Max API, this is an executable file, so we can run it like this, .golangmaxapi, and this is going to start the server. So that's what we need to run once the container is initialized. So I'm going to copy that here. And that's pretty much all we need. So I'm going to clear this, and I'm going to run the command to build the image. So first I'm going to run Docker images to list all the existing images. So we don't have any images. So I'm going to run Docker build -t Golang API. This is going to be the name of the image and the directory that includes the Docker file. So I'm going to run this, and this is going to take a while, and it's going to run each of these sentences. Now it's downloading all the dependencies that we are going to use in our application. Okay, now it's going to copy all the source files. It's going to set the port for the application, and it's going to build the application. Okay, now our Golang API image is ready. So if I run Docker images, I should see the image listed there, here. And now I'm going to run the container using that image. So Docker run -p, and here I need to specify the local port and the container port. Let's say that I want to use 8080 locally, and the container port is 8000, the one that we specified here. And now I need to specify the image name, that is Golang API. Okay, now the application is running, and here I need to change the port here by 8080. And if I run this, so this returns an empty array because we don't have any posts. I need to change the port here as well. And I'm going to create a new post. And now if I run the get operation, yes, I get the post that I already created. Okay, now we know that our container is running. I'm going to stop this. And if I call this again, yeah, we don't get any response because the container is not running. So that's pretty much all I have for today. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to download the Golang cheat sheet. There is a link in the description below the video. And I see you guys in the next one. Take care. Bye.